shocked the civilized world.
Everything.
Our embassy has been seized and more than 60 American citizens continue to be held as hostages.
If we're going to go, then we need to go now.
Ben Affleck is hoping to go 3 for 3 as a director with his new movie Argo, and it seems that he might have just caught a coup. The political thriller, directed by and starring Affleck, follows the real-life story of the Iran hostage crisis in 1979. The tense film tells the story of a CIA agent who, in 1980, arranged the rescue of 6 American diplomats stranded in post-revolution Iran.
Deliver the 6 bikes, provide them with maps.
Or you could just send in training wheels and meet them at the border with Gatorade.
It's gonna take a miracle to get them out.
Buddy man, what are we watching?
I got an idea.
They're a Canadian film crew for a science fiction movie.
I fly into Tehran. We all fly out together as a film crew.
I need you to help me make a fake movie.
So you want to come to Hollywood and act like a big shot without actually doing anything?
Yeah.
With Argo, right, Affleck manages to weave a detailed, though dramatized, account of a politically charged, true-life event with a skewering of Hollywood. We speak to the director, who tells us more about the film.
It's gonna be a fake hit.
You don't have a better bad idea than this?
This is the best bad idea we have, sir. By far.
It is interesting. It's different, you know. Although I have to say, because I've been an actor for a while, I'm really used to being on a set acting in front of the camera. So that doesn't feel like extra work. You know what I mean? It feels like the normal investment you have. The problem is that the time you take to think about your performance and what you're going to do just takes away from the amount of time you have to, you know, think about what you're going to do as a director. So the big problem is just you know those two jobs fighting over time, and you only have a limited amount because, as they say, time is money. Sometimes you're sort of peripherally aware of stuff that's going on when you're acting in a scene, and you know, a lot of actors, I think, you know, acting, directing, it's about taste. You know, feeling as though the scene is working or the scene isn't working, or liking what's going on with the extras. And a lot of actors will, you know, have the instincts about that. So it's not uncommon to have those kinds of, you know, sensory perceptions while you're working on a movie. It's just that you have to sort of learn to cultivate them. You know what I mean? You have to really learn to listen. And then I just do it a bunch and then go over to the monitor and say, sort of, did anybody notice anything weird? Obviously want to have the best actors possible, but I also wanted people that I could make look just like the real people, because I wanted that correlation, that similarity with the true story to show people that, in fact, this is real, it really happened. And so that, you know, when you're in a magazine or in a book or at the picture at the end of the movie, you could be kind of struck by the similarities.
Who are the last 3 prime ministers?
But it turned out that, you know, mustaches and glasses and a wardrobe kind of goes a long way toward getting people to look like the other different people in the 70s. And so what I did that I think was helpful,
was
I made them all live in this on the set, in the house that we dressed as their ambassador residence in Tehran.
What's your middle name?
And we put the period movies in, period magazines and books and their wardrobe. And they had to live, I couldn't find 70s like food boxes, but they had to live together and get used to one another as if they'd been cooped up together. And when they got out, you really did, it felt different. It felt like these are people who knew each other in a more intimate way. You know, when you say a movie is based on true events, particularly a movie where it's as outrageous as this one, and extraordinary with a thriller and a comedy and a CIA story and all this stuff, you have a responsibility to stay close to the truth. You know, when you tell the audience this is a true story, you have to make it as true as you possibly can. So I kept the spine and the heart of the story is absolutely true. These Americans escaped from the embassy when it was taken over. They stayed with the Canadians. A CIA agent with a Hollywood Oscar-winning makeup artist came up with a plan to get them out that involved pretending they were making a movie. That's all real. John Chambers, the makeup artist that was friends with Tony Mendez, an absolutely real guy. He also looks almost exactly like John Goodman, you know. And he won the first Oscar for makeup. He did Planet of the Apes. He was the head of makeup for Warner Brothers. But he also had his secret compartment makeup, you know, drawer with a lock on it. That's where he kept all the CIA disguises, you know, the masks that got people out of, you know, snuck people out of Southeast Asia and that kind of thing. So that was really true. The Alan Arkin character is a bit of a composite, and we made him a little bit more of a sort of old, famous, you know, worldly producer. The real guy, Seidel, was a little bit less, had a little bit less interesting history. And I thought Alan, you know, to play that, you would get an even better sense into Hollywood, both the part that you kind of roll your eyes at and the part that's really interesting.